What I'd like to do is wrap up with Patricia's comment. She says, as a believer, I just made a big financial error by using a large asset to pay off mortgage in full. Can you help? Love to ask you a question. Help. Okay. Should I get a HELOC, another type of loan? Home is worth $1.6 million. I feel so stupid.
Well, all right. So first of all, yeah, you're in a good place. Don't feel stupid. Just breathe.
Yeah.
It's going to be okay. Frankly, you're in a good position. Are you in the most efficient position? No. Are you in a bad position? No. So don't feel stressed out. It comes down to what else do you have? And so, you know, if you said, Joe, I've got $1.6 million here and I don't have anything else. I've put everything that I have into this one asset. Well, that's probably not going to be optimal. However, if you said, Joe, should I get a, you said here, HELOC, should I refinance? And I know, Denzel, I know you talk a lot about this kind of stuff too, but for me, I like flexibility. I don't like having a lot of money tied up in an asset that I can't access. So let's go back to what we were talking about safety-wise. We talked about the rules had changed. So there's two times that you're the safest. One, when you have the biggest mortgage possible in your house. And the second is when you have it completely paid off. So Patricia, you're not in a bad position. Don't stress. Are there opportunities? Yeah, lots. Denzel can help you. I'd be glad to answer some questions. Depending on what your goals are and your motivation, I would be remiss to even try to give a whole lot of details right now. But I'll tell you this, if you're paying it down, the reason why banks have paid significant money to teach people to make extra payments, the reason why they focus so heavily on 15-year mortgages and encouraging you to pay down your mortgage as fast as possible is because every dollar that you put into your equity makes them safer. Let me explain. On average, it costs a bank about 20% of the value of a house to foreclose, 20%. So if you have a mortgage greater than 20%, then they're underwater. What does that mean? It means that it would cost them money to actually foreclose on you. Do you think that makes them less or more likely to help you?
Can you repeat that one more time? Because I think that flew over my head.
If you owe more than 80%,
okay,
and it costs them 20% to foreclose. Let's say you owe 85% of the mortgage. So let's go back to our $100,000 house. You owe $85,000. If they let's say you miss a payment or two. If they start the foreclosure process, they're going to lose $5,000 if they foreclose on you.
Got it. So the likelihood of them foreclosing on someone.
Are they going to be more likely to work with you to get you in line?
Yes.
If you owe more than it's going to cost them, than if you owe less.
Yeah, they're going to want to work with that person.
And the more that you have paid down,
the less,
the better position they're going to be in. Because it's typically 80% of what they sell the house for. And so when you look at their sale price, if you've ever gone out and bought a house and seen an REO, real estate owned by the bank where they foreclosed on it, they're not always super quick to just negotiate the best deal they can possibly negotiate. They don't really care. They're getting what they can get, but they're really looking out for their investment, not to get anything more. So if you've paid your house down to $50,000, I would say the sweet spot is as much as you can put yourself into. Is it Menor?
Oh, so, Mr. Ramos. Oh, okay.
You can avoid PMI in a few different ways. That's a mortgage conversation, but there's other ways around PMI. But you know what it really comes down to is all of those expenses are just expenses. It's a numbers game. And so what's your opportunity with the money? If I got I'll give you an example. Let me come back to that in a second. Back to you, Pearl, to your specific issue. I would look at two things. I would look at your opportunities out there. Denzel, are they offering all-in-ones right now or are they locked up right now?
As far as I'm concerned, I have about, I think, I spoke to 1 to 2 clients that recently got their all-in-one loan. So I'm going to say that they're still writing them at the moment.
Okay. So there's a loan called an all-in-one loan. It's effectively, and it they don't bill it like this, but it's effectively a first lien HELOC. Okay. With, it gives you the ability to have check writing capabilities. The reason it's called an all-in-one, and you've probably heard this someplace else, but if you haven't, I'll just give you a quick overview. It's called an all-in-one because you effectively use it like a checking account. And so when you borrow money from it, you can write a check and pay things and go from there. And there's a whole cash flow mechanism that we don't have time to get into. Denzel can definitely help you with that.
Yeah, and I've done content on it. So they're a little familiar with it. Mostly.
Perfect. So if it were me, I would do something along that lines. Right now, they, at least the last time I saw, I haven't looked in the past month or two, but last time I saw, they would loan up to 80% on a personal residence. And so when I say loan, they effectively give you access to it without necessarily, you don't pay for it unless you're using it.
Yeah, right.
And so what happens is if you have 1.6 million paid off, then that would put you in position to get 1 point minus 320 would be 1.28, $1,280,000 of access, so that you then have access to that cash to deploy into whatever opportunities you wanted. And while you're deploying that capital, you know exactly what your expense is, but you can simultaneously reduce that with your cash flow of any other income that's coming in personally. And you can have that direct deposited. If you have a typical W-2 type of a job, you could have that direct deposited in there and you could just keep it moving. You can write checks directly out of it. You can pay a lot of your bills with a credit card, get the points, which isn't gonna make you rich, but it may make you feel rich when you're taking vacations on points. You know, it's gonna put you in position where you might as well enjoy the lifestyle that you've earned. And so, you know, when you get into a position where you're able to get that money working, now you're able to recapture lots of things. So that's what I would look at just off the top of my head on your situation is ways to access the cash without necessarily having to pay for it if you're not able to deploy it. Does that make sense?
Yeah. And then Patricia wrote, you know, sounds like a reverse mortgage.
It's not a reverse mortgage.
Yeah, not the case. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not a reverse mortgage. It's very, very different. Reverse mortgage would actually take your house effectively from you. You'd have to live in it and you'd have to be, I don't know how old you are, but you know, typically you'd have to be upper 60s to get into a reverse mortgage. And that is designed for people who are needing to live off the house while having a benefit in the house and continuing to stay there until they die. And so they're effectively dwindling down their equity while continuing to live there. And then if it gets to a place to where they run out of equity, then they are still able to continue living there because that's part of the equation. That's the reverse mortgage. What this is this is an actual effective tool that is, that's a line of credit. And it just gives you a line of credit against the property, but it gives you access to it back and forth to where you can put money in, take money out. Interesting fact, I was told by one of the reps that it was created in 1996. And since then they have had zero defaults. Now I'll tell you, the interest rate is higher than a traditional fixed mortgage. But once again, I've already shown you that just because it's a higher interest rate doesn't necessarily mean that it costs more. Because when you factor in opportunity cost and everything else, and the amount of money that you're losing with all the money getting tied up in the property, it catches up pretty quickly.
Right. And so you can get out much higher, right?
Exactly. So that's really the biggest difference there. 72. Perfect. Yeah. It just gives you access to it, Patricia. So it puts you in a position where if you don't have anything to use it for, no problem. You don't have to use it, but if you have access to it, let's say that knock on wood, it'll never happen. But let's say an emergency came up. Let's say there was a medical bill that came up. Let's say that there was something that came into play. Well, it gives you access to that cash where if you wait until, it's just like asset protection. Asset protection is critical But most people don't think about it until they're already in a jam. And by then it's too late. You can't change your structure.
Yeah.
And so it's the same way with a loan. The bank is willing to give you the loan when they're willing to give it to you. But if you get to a place to where you need it, they're likely not going to.